सब्सक्राइब एंड हिट द बेल आइकन फॉर मोर नोटिफिकेशंस। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। टुडे लेट्स डिस्कस द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस इन कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स। ओके, कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स इन यूनिट वन इज नथिंग बट डेटा कम्युनिकेशन। इन डेटा कम्युनिकेशन द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस आर इन लॉन्ग क्वेश्चंस द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस आर RS-232 इंटरफेसिंग। RS-232 इंटरफेसिंग एंड द सेकेंड इम्पॉर्टेंट आंसर इज ISO-OSI मॉडल। दीज टू आर वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स एंड द थर्ड इम्पॉर्टेंट लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन इज TCP/IP मॉडल। दीज आर द थ्री वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस इन यूनिट वन। कमिंग टू शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस, द शॉर्ट क्वेश्चंस विच आर वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट आर कॉम्पोनेंट्स एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ डेटा कम्युनिकेशन। दिस इज वन ऑफ द शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन विच इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड नेक्स्ट वन इज नेटवर्क क्राइटेरिया। दिस इज अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन एंड लाइन कोडिंग। गाइडेड एंड अनगाइडेड मीडिया प्रोटोकॉल्स एंड टोपोलॉजीज इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज फिजिकल स्ट्रक्चर। दे मे आस्क यू लाइक दिस ऑल्सो, वॉट आर फिजिकल स्ट्रक्चर्स? डोंट गेट कन्फ्यूज, फिजिकल स्ट्रक्चर्स इज नथिंग बट टोपोलॉजीज ओनली। ओके, दीज आर फ्यू इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस इन यूनिट वन कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स। ओके, एंड द यूनिट वन नेम इज डेटा कम्युनिकेशन। कमिंग टू यूनिट टू, द लॉन्ग क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट। आउट ऑफ देम द क्वेश्चंस आर नॉइसलेस चैनल्स, noisy channels and selective repeat ARQ, go back and ARQ, bridges, IEEE concepts, etc. Okay, and coming to short, हैमिंग कोड, CRC, अलोहा, सिंपल्स एंड स्टॉप एंड वेट ARQ एक्सेट्रा। ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू थर्ड यूनिट, यूनिट टू is also very important, don't neglect it. Coming to unit 3, the name of the unit is network layer internetworks. Okay, in this the important questions are logical addressing, unicast routing protocols, unicast routing protocols and distance vector routing and link state routing and path vector routing एंड लास्ट बट नॉट लीस्ट बी जी पी, दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके एंड कमिंग टू यूनिट 4, द इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस आर ट्रांसमिशन ट्रांसमिशन कंट्रोल प्रोटोकॉल एंड यूजर डेटाग्राम प्रोटोकॉल. ट्रांसमिशन कंट्रोल प्रोटोकॉल एंड डेटाग्राम प्रोटोकॉल. ओके एंड अदर वन इज कंजेशन कंट्रोल. कंजेशन कंट्रोल एंड क्वालिटी ऑफ सर्विसेस. ओके कंजेशन कंट्रोल एंड क्वालिटी ऑफ सर्विसेस. कमिंग टू लास्ट यूनिट यूनिट 5, द नेम इज सॉकेट प्रोग्रामिंग. द नेम ऑफ द फिफ्थ यूनिट इज सॉकेट प्रोग्रामिंग. ओके इन दिस द इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस आर सॉकेट एड्रेस, एलिमेंटरी एलिमेंटरी सॉकेट सिस्टम कॉल्स, एलिमेंटरी सॉकेट सिस्टम कॉल्स एंड एसिंक्रोनस एसिंक्रोनस इनपुट इनपुट आउटपुट मल्टीप्लेक्सिंग आउट ऑफ बैंड डेटा. दिस इज ऑल वन क्वेश्चन. ओके दिस इज एसिंक्रोनस इनपुट आउटपुट मल्टीप्लेक्सिंग आउट ऑफ बैंड डेटा. ओके एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन इज इंटरनेट इंटरनेट सुपर सर्वर. These are the few important questions. But hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video I am going to begin data communication and networks tutorial. Okay, this is also called computer networks. Now let us know what is data communication. Okay, data communication means exchange of the data between two devices. Okay, which are connected together. See, it's very easy. This is one of the most important as well as most interesting subject. Okay, listen carefully. I'm going to explain the definition of data communication. Okay, data communication is exchange of the data between two devices which are connected together. Okay, let there be two devices. Okay, they should be connected together, then the communication can occur in between these two devices, which is known as data communication. Okay, now we just read that, like we just studied that there will be communication between two devices. Communication is nothing but flow of data. Okay, now what is data flow? Okay, what is data flow? Data flow means in between two devices there will be flow of data. Okay, this device may send the information to this device, or this device may send the information to this device. This is called data flow, means flow of data between devices. Okay, the devices can flow the data among them in three types. Okay, first type is simplex. First and simple category of data flow is simplex. Simplex means if there are two stations or devices, station 1 and station 2. Okay, station 1 and station 2. Under simplex, only one device will be transmitting the data and other device will just receive the data. Okay, device 1 is sending the data and device 2 is receiving the data. Okay, station 2, that is device 2, cannot send back the data to station 1. It can just receive the data from the station 1, means only one way flow of data. Okay, it can send but it cannot receive back. Okay, so this is just sending device, this is just receiving device. Okay, this is quite simplex. Second one is half duplex. Half duplex is nothing but there are two devices. Okay, this is device 1 and this is device 2. Okay, this can send the data and this in turn can send the data, means device 1 can send the data to device 2 and in return device 2 can send the data to device 2, but this both cannot happen at a time. Means first device 1, like any device, not just device 1, any device can send the data, and after this data is completely sent to other device then it will stop sending, like because all the data is already sent, then it will stop sending. Then this device starts to send the data to the another device. Okay, first it sends the data, next it sends the data. This both actions will not happen at a time, only this device will send. After completely sending the data it have to wait, and then this device in turn sends the data to this. Okay, both can receive and transfer but not at the same time. Okay, example is if there is a highway road. Okay, if there is a highway road, okay, it is one way road. The one way road means vehicles can go in this direction as well as go in this direction, but not at a time. Okay, if at a time they goes, accident can happen. So either it should go or it should go, both can go but not at the same time. Okay, this is half duplex. The third one is duplex or full duplex. Okay, it can be called as duplex or full duplex. See the difference between duplex and full duplex. So half duplex and full duplex, now you can clearly understand. I'll explain you. Okay, there are two devices. Okay, there are two devices, device 1, device 2. Okay, device 1 and device 2. Device 2 is sending the data, at the same time receiving the data. Simple concept. It can send the data, at the same time it can receive the data. Okay, this is called duplex. Okay, it is like two-way road. In the two-way road, vehicles can go like this and vehicle can go like this at the same time. Okay, this is the example of full duplex. Okay, these are the three categories. Welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video we are going to discuss about different categories of networks. Okay, there are three categories of networks, that is three types of networks. Now let us discuss about each and every network. Okay, first network is LAN. LAN stands for local area network. Okay, local area network is the network which is used within the same building, within offices, within institutes. Okay, so for this we use local area network. Why? Because within building means there is less distance, the distance between the devices will be less. Within offices means the distance will be less. Within the same institutes means also the device can be the distance between the devices will be less, because local area network will support only up to few kilometers. It cannot share the device or it cannot access the device if it is beyond the limit. Okay, it supports only up to few kilometers. Okay, why we use LAN means we use LAN to share the peripherals. Now let us understand what is meant by peripherals. Peripherals are the devices which are connected to the system. Okay, this is computer. Okay, for computer mouse will be connected, for computer keyboard will be connected, for computer speaker will be connected, and printer will be connected, etc. Okay, so these all the devices which are connected to the computer. So the device which are connected to the computer are called peripherals. Okay, mouse and keyboard will have, like, for every device there will be mouse, for every device there will be keyboard. But coming to the peripheral devices such as speakers and printers, the company cannot provide each and every individual employee with single printer. Means if there are 1,000 employees in an office, the company cannot provide 1,000 speakers and 1,000 printers. Okay, this is not possible, this is not practically possible. So that's why we use LAN to share the peripherals. Means using LAN within the same office or within the same building, LAN allows us to share the peripheral devices between various systems and various computers. Okay, that is the advantage of LAN. But the disadvantage is LAN can be used only within office and only within few kilometers. Okay, if the distance is more, we can't prefer LAN. Okay, this is called the LAN. Now let us discuss about second category of the network, which is called MAN. MAN stands for Metropolitan Area Network. Okay, the disadvantage of LAN is it can cover only up to few kilometers. Okay, and keeping this disadvantages in mind, we came out with a new concept called MAN. MAN can be used within cities and within medium distance and within remote areas. Remote areas means like where there are less or no population. Okay, those areas are called remote areas. In these places only the MAN is mostly used. Okay, and advantage of MAN is MAN can provide the network between cities, between states, between different offices, between different buildings, between different institutes, etc. Okay, but whereas LAN can provide in the same office and same building, but MAN provides the network to different offices and different buildings. This is the advantage of MAN. Third kind of network is WAN, means Wide Area Network. Name itself tells you it is a network which covers the wide area. Wide area means from one country to another country, WAN can be used across the globe. Means all over the globe, WAN can be used. That is, if you want to transfer the network or share the network from one country to another country, we can prefer WAN. Okay, it is having highest network. Okay, it is the highest network with highest capacity. Okay, these are three kinds of networks. Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this tutorial we are going to discuss about star topology. Now first let us see the architecture of the star topology. Okay, this is the architecture of star topology. There will be a central hub, and to that hub all the devices will be connected. This is device 1, this is device 2, and this is device n. Okay, so if If this device wants to transfer the information to these devices, to remaining devices, it cannot directly transfer because there is no direct connection to this device to another devices. Okay, so then what is the case is this device will first transfer the information to the hub, and this hub will check to what device this device one wanted to transfer the information. See, if this device wanted to transfer information to device 2, first it will transfer to hub, and from hub the hub will transfer the same information to device 2. Thus the information will be reaching from device 1 to device 2. This is the working form of star topology. Okay, now let us see the advantages and disadvantages of the star topology architecture. Coming to advantages, it requires less cost. Means we can construct or we can buy the star topology with less cost. It is cost effective. It is less expensive. Okay. Second advantage is central hub is the second advantage, because all the information will stored here. Okay, we should transfer here from the central hub will take the responsibility to transfer the image to the destination. So central hub is one of the advantage. Okay, and third advantage is less cabling. I will explain you what is less cabling, but before understanding the concept of less cabling, you should watch out my previous video, which is on mesh topology. Okay, because this is the advantage which came out from the disadvantage of the mesh topology. So in order to understand this particular point, watch out my previous video on mesh topology. Okay, now I'll explain you less cabling means. The previous topology, that is the star topology, second kind of topology. The first kind of topology is mesh topology. In mesh topology, the architecture will be like this. This is one device, this is one device, this is one device, and this is one device, and this is another device. Okay, this device will be connected to this, this device will be connected to this, like this, with a form of links. Okay, see, in order to establish a connection from 1 to 2, this link should be laid out. Link is nothing but wiring. Okay, wires, internal wires should be laid out. Same here, same here, same here, and same here. See, there is lot of wires in the mesh topology. Okay, means it requires more storage. So we came out with the concept of the star topology. In star topology, there is an advantage of less cabling. Less cabling means, see the architecture. Here there is a hub. Okay, hub is the central device which is connected to all the devices. Okay, so there is no requirement of wiring. Okay, there is no requirement or less requirement of wiring, so it saves a lot of memory storage. These are the advantages of the star topology. Now let us see what are the disadvantages of star topology. Okay, let's start. Coming to the disadvantages of the star topology, one disadvantage is dependency. Dependency means, I will explain you now. We already came to know that if device 1 wants to transfer the information to device 2 or device N or any other device, it should first transfer the information to the hub. Hub will take the responsibility of sending that information to the final destination. Okay, so this is the concept of the star topology. But if If the star topology, if the hub in star topology failed working, if there is any problem with the hub, then though it transfers the information to the hub, it cannot work properly and it cannot send the final information to the destination. So this is one of the advantage. And second advantage is we have the concept here as each node must be linked to central hub, so there may be traffic. See, I will explain you. All the devices will be sending the information to the hub. So here there may be occurrence of traffic. These are the disadvantages and advantages of the star topology. That's it for today. Friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about the ring topology. Okay, this is the architecture of the ring topology. These are called the stations. Okay, these are all called as stations. Okay. Stations, and this is called as, these are called as repeaters. Okay, now let us go through the concept of ring topology. Okay, first, in ring topology, all the stations will be connected to the links with the help of repeaters. See, the stations are connected to the cables with the help of repeaters. Okay, these are repeaters. With the help of repeaters, the stations are connected to the topology. Now let us understand why we use repeaters. Okay, see, generally when we want to transfer the information from one station to another station, see, example, this is station 1, this is station 2, 3, 4, 5, and let it be station N. Okay, see, when we want to transfer the information from the station 1 to station 4, it can travel in this direction, like it can send it to station 2, and from then it can send to station 3 and then to station 4. Okay, see, the information will also pass through repeaters. Okay, also pass through repeaters. Now what is the work which is done by the repeater? Now let us understand the repeater. See, the repeater will transfer the information from one station to other station till it reaches the destination station, as well as it generates the bits. Okay, see, listen, try to understand the concept. It is one of the most easy and important topology. Try to understand very carefully. Okay, now let us understand what will the repeater do. What will the repeater do means repeater regenerates the bits and passes them forward. Means I will say you see carefully. See, this station wanted to send the information to station 4, as it can't do directly because there is no direct connection from station 1 to station 4. The intermediary stations which are in between station 1 and station 4 will help to reach the information from the source to destination. Source means a source is the device which want to transfer the information. Destination is the device to which the information is to be reached. Okay, see, the repeater will have the information and it will also have some bits like this. Okay, the bits along with the information, the bits also will be transferred from one repeater to another repeater. Okay, this is the work which is done by the bits. Okay, and there are few advantages and disadvantages of ring topology. Now let us go through it. Okay, advantages of ring topology. Coming to the first advantage, it is very easy to install. Like, ring topology can be installed very easily. This is the first advantage, and the second advantage is easy to reconfigure. Means if you want to configure the topology, it is very easy when it comes to ring topology. Okay, this is second advantage. The third advantage is devices. Each device is linked only to its neighbor devices. So it is very easy to find the fault. I will explain you what does this point mean. See, let us consider station 4. Station 4 is connected only to station 3 and station 5. It means station 4 is connected only to its neighboring devices. Okay, if I want to transfer the information from station 4 to station N, I can transfer like this. Okay, if the information is reached till here and then if the information is lost, then I can easily know that here there is a fault like that, because this station has only one intermediary node as station 5. Okay, if I want to transfer to, information to station 5, it can pass from station 4 to 5 and 5 to N. Okay, if it reached till here and then if it is lost, the fault will be here itself. So it is very easy to find the fault. Okay, now let us see what are the disadvantages of ring topology. Okay, the first disadvantage is unidirectional traffic is a disadvantage. Unidirectional traffic is a disadvantage. Why? Because see, if I wanted to transfer the information from the station 1 to station 3, it can only go in one direction. In this way, it cannot go, means it can even go like this, but if I wanted to transfer the information, it should either go like this or it should either go like this, but it can't go in both the directions. So unidirectional traffic is a problem, because if there are three devices, this can travel like this or this can travel like this. Okay, there is only unidirection, so all the devices have only one path, like this only it can travel. So when we follow the same route again and again, there will be traffic occurred. Okay, this is the one of the disadvantages. Second advantage, disadvantage is fault isolation. And another disadvantage is that, see, I want to transfer the information from device 1 to device 3 or station 1 to station 3. Okay, if the connection is lost here, or if the connection, in this connection if there is an error, the transfer of the information cannot be happened. This is another advantage in ring topology. So these are the advantages and disadvantages and the concept of ring topology. Thank you. So friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to discuss about physical topologies. Physical topologies is one of the most important basic concept in computer network and data communication. Okay, before starting about categories of topologies, first let us understand what is meaning of topology. Okay, topology is nothing but it is the representation between links and linking devices. Now let us try to understand what is this. Okay, what is the meaning of this? See, generally if there are two devices, if we want these two devices to communicate, or if we want this device to transfer the information to this device, or this in turn transfer the information to this device, For this, we should establish a connection in between this, like physical connection, which is called as a link. This is called as link, and these devices are called linked devices. Okay, these devices are called as linked devices. Okay, see, topology explains us the relationship of linked devices and link. Okay, means topology. With the help of topology, we can understand the relationship representation between linked devices and the link. This is only called as topology. Now, first, let us see what are the types of topologies. There are actually five types of topologies, but we care mostly on first four types. Okay, first type of topology is mesh topology. Mesh topology. Okay, mesh topology. Coming to mesh topology, it is having a point to point connection. Point to point connection. Okay, now let us understand what is point to point connection. If a device is linked only to single other device, okay, if the link is only if this device is linked only to one another only one device, then it is called point to point connection. Okay, means there is only one point connection between the devices. Okay, and multi point connection means a device is linked to more than one device, it is called as a multi point connection. See, this device is linked to more than one device, so this is a multi point connection. Coming to mesh topology, it is a point to point connection, it is not multi point connection. Okay, mesh topology is a point to point connection. Now let's discuss in detail about mesh topology. Okay, mesh topology, first point in mesh topology is what? It is a point to point connection. There is a point to point connection. Okay, and it is a dedicated connection. Dedicated connection means if there are two devices, it is said to be dedicated connection. Okay, because dedicated connection means the traffic occurs only in between these two devices is called dedicated connection. Traffic means, see, example, this is device A, this is device B. This can send 500 words per second. Okay, this can receive 200 words per second. Okay, this can send 500 words per second, and this can receive 200 words per second. Means this device is slow. So once it sent 500 words, it cannot receive all at a time because its capacity is to receive only 200 words per second. Then it will, after receiving 200 words, it will slow down. Okay, then traffic will be occurred. Okay, this is known as traffic. Okay, now let us see more about mesh topology. Before seeing more about mesh topology, let us see the diagram of mesh topology. Mesh topology diagram is as follows. Okay, these are all stations or devices, anything we can call them as. Okay, see, I already said you in mesh topology, there is a point to point connection. Okay, point to point connection means the connection should be only between two devices. Okay, but any links may be there. Means, example, this device is connected to only one device, and it again can be connected to another device through different links, but only with one link it cannot connect with more than one device. If so, it becomes multipoint. But actually it is not multipoint, it is point to point. So now let us see, this station is connected to this device, so it is establishing a point to point connection. Again, this is a separate device connection, so again this is point to point connection. like this. Again, this is point to point connection. This is point to point connection. There may be multiple point to point connections, but not multi point connection. Multiple point to point means this is one point to point connection. 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 And this can be connected like this. Point to point means only one link, only two devices are connected. This is also one point to point connection because only two devices are connected. This can be two devices connected, point to point connection like this. Okay. Multi point means this connecting to more than two devices, but this is not the case. There is only point to point device connection between two stations. Again, this may establish with this. This may establish with this point to point connection, but not like this. Okay. Now, in order to know how many connections does this have, like one device is having many links, right? Many links. Okay. Now, to understand how many links a device is having, there is a formula, that is n into n minus 1. I will explain you why this formula came. See, n into n minus 1 is, this is one device, this is second device, so on up to 3. This is n minus 1 device, this is n device, okay? Like this, let it be, there are n devices, okay, in this topology. If this is a device, n, this can be connected into multiple devices, but n, kada, this is n, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is n minus 2, this is n minus 1, this is n, okay? See, this device can connect to this, this device can connect to this device can connect to this, simultaneously it can connect up to n minus 1, but device n cannot connect to itself, okay? There cannot be point to point connection to itself, so we have to deduct one means this is one device, right? This is one device, so we are multiplying with n because there are n devices, and deducting n minus 1 because a device cannot lay the connection to itself, so we have to deduct that one device, so I am subtracting with n minus 1, okay? So this is the formula to know the connections in the mesh topology. That's it for today. In my coming up video, I'm going to discuss about more other topologies such as star topology, bus topology, ring topology, and hybrid topology. Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about bus topology. Okay, before discussing about bus topology, let us check out the architecture of bus topology, okay? This is the cable end, and this is another cable end, okay? Here there will be devices or stations, okay? And these stations will be connected to the end cable. The connection point is called the tap, and this is called the drop line, okay? This is common to every station. This is drop line and this is tap. Okay, this is the architecture of the bus topology. Now let's discuss about bus topology, okay? Coming to bus topology is a multi-point connection. Multi-point connection. Okay, multi-point connection is nothing but one device will be connected to more than one devices. Okay, see, this device is connected to multiple devices. So this is called the multi-point connection. Okay, bus topology is a multi-point connection, is having a multi-point connection. Okay, and the nodes are connected to the bus cable. See, these are the nodes. Nodes, stations, devices, anything we can call. The nodes are connected to the cable end, to the bus cable, with the help of taps and drop line. Okay, drop line provides the connection and tap will sink into the cable. This is called tap. Okay, and next important thing is, as the information will be transferring forward to one cable end to another cable end, or one device to another device, the clarity and the quality will be reducing, because the energy will be transformed into heat. Example, let us consider this device is sending the information to another devices. Okay, as the distance is increasing, the information will be transformed to heat. Okay, transformed into heat. The information will be transformed into heat as the distance increases. Okay, so the bus topology is used only for mostly short distances. Okay, this is the concept of the bus topology. Now let us discuss about advantages and disadvantages of bus topology. First, let us discuss about advantages. Coming to advantages, okay, bus topology is very easy to install. Ease of installation. Installation ease means it is very easy to install. Okay, this is the first advantage. And the second advantage is, we can use bus topology for transfer of information or data. Okay, we can use the topology for the transfer of the information or data. Okay, and coming to disadvantages, not only advantages, bus topology also has different kinds of disadvantages. Okay, now let's learn about them. The disadvantage is called the fault tolerance is very little. Okay, next, fault isolation. Next, difficulty in reconnection. Okay, and these three are the disadvantages. Fault tolerance is very little. Fault tolerance means, see, example is a device fails. Okay, if the device fails or if the architecture has any problem, it takes some time to recover from the fault. Means if there is any fault in it or if there is any problem in it, the time taken by the architecture to recover back to the normal situation is called fault tolerance. Okay, the fault tolerance is very little. Means if there is any fault or if there is any error or problem in bus topology, it takes more time to recover and to be back to normal. Okay, that is one disadvantage. Second disadvantage is fault isolation. Okay, fault isolation and difficulty in reconnection. Fault isolation and means it is very hard to find the fault. That is one disadvantage. And other disadvantage is difficulty in reconnection. See, this is the architecture. Okay, if I decided to establish another connection here, like another station, if I wanted to add to the cable end to the bus topology, it is not so easy. It takes time and effort to add the new connections to the bus topology. Okay, this is also one of the disadvantages. That's it for today. These are the advantage. This is the explanation tutorial and advantages and disadvantages of the bus topology. Hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching. I have already uploaded and done with videos like mesh topology and star topology also. So please do watch them to get more and more knowledge about the physical structure of topologies. Welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to discuss about very important long answer in data communications, that is ISO OSI model and its layers. Okay, ISO OSI ISI. ISO stands for International Standard Organization. It is an organization which denotes the standards of the networks, okay? Networks and other products. OSI is a model, okay? It is a model. OSI stands for Open System Interconnection, okay? OSI is developed in late 1970s, okay? It was introduced in late 1970s, okay? OSI model is used for transferring of the information from one device to another device irrespective of the underlying architecture. That means without considering the underlying architecture, like without considering the architecture of a device, we can transfer the information from one device to another device with the help of OSI, okay? And coming to the OSI layers, there are 7 layers in ISO OSI model. They are application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. These are the 7 ISO OSI layers which are very important and basic, okay? Now let us see what is the architecture of the ISO OSI model, okay? Coming to the architecture is like this. These are the 7 layers. And these are the 7 layers of another device. Okay. This is the 7 layers of device A. And these are the 7 layers of device A and B. Okay. And in between these devices, there will be the intermediary nodes. This is computer A. This is computer B. Okay. In between these systems, there will be intermediary nodes. Okay. This acts as an interface between the computer A and computer B. Okay. And in between the layers of the single device, there will be interface. See, this is application layer, this is presentation layer, this is session layer, this is transport layer, this is network layer, this is data link layer, and this is physical layer, okay? In between all these devices, there should be a connection. That connection is known as interface. That connection is known as interface. Okay, in between every device, there will be an interface. Okay, and from physical device of physical layer of device A to physical layer of device B, there will be a intermediary nodes again, okay, and again there will be the interface between the layers of device B. Why this interface? Means the interface is used to transfer the data or the information from one layer to another layer. I will explain you how. If there are 2 devices without a connection, we can't transfer the information, okay? So this connection is an interface. It is called an interface in this model, okay? And coming to this, I'll explain you why is this. This is called the transmission medium. This connection is called transmission medium. Transmission medium, it provides the physical transmission between the physical layers of device A and B. And the work of physical layer is, physical layer, see, generally the computer A will send the information in the form of data. बट वी ऑल नो दैट इनसाइड द आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ द कंप्यूटर डेटा कैन नॉट बी अंडरस्टूड. इट शुड बी कन्वर्टेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बिट्स. ओके, बिट्स मीन्स 0101 लाइक दैट. सो वंस इट रीचेस टू फिजिकल लेयर, फिजिकल लेयर देर विल बी डेटा, द सेम डेटा विच कंप्यूटर ए सेंट टू फिजिकल लेयर लाइक दिस. सी आई विल से यू फर्स्ट, कंप्यूटर ए विल सेंड द इंफॉर्मेशन टू एप्लीकेशन लेयर. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस इंटरफेस द एप्लीकेशन लेयर विल सेंड द सेम इंफॉर्मेशन टू प्रेजेंटेशन लेयर. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस इंटरफेस द सेम डेटा विल बी ट्रांसफर टू सेशन लेयर. इन द सेम वे डेटा लिंक लेयर विल ट्रांसफर द सेम डेटा टू फिजिकल लेयर. ओके, सो द डेटा इज अवेलेबल नाउ इन फिजिकल लेयर, बट द फिजिकल लेयर कैनॉट सेंड द डेटा टू द डिवाइस बी, फिजिकल लेयर इन द डिवाइस बी डायरेक्टली, बिकॉज वी कैनॉट ट्रांसफर द डेटा एज इट इज़ फ्रॉम वन डिवाइस टू अनदर डिवाइस, बिकॉज द कंप्यूटर कैनॉट अंडरस्टैंड द डेटा, इट कैन जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द बिट्स. सो फिजिकल लेयर विल कन्वर्ट द डेटा इंटू बिट्स. ओके, नाउ the bits will be transferred to this data and those bits will again be transferred converted into data. Okay, see, now here the data is in the form of bits. Here the physical layer will receive the data in the form of bits and those bits again will be converted into data and will be sent to the data link layer. And those data with the help of interface, it will be sent to network layer. In the same way, it will reach to computer B. So, computer B will receive the same data which computer A wants to send. Okay, this is the architecture of the ISO OSI model. Okay, now let us see what are the layers and what are the work done by the ISO OSI layer. Okay, now let us discuss in detail about this. Okay, now first layer, which is most important layer, is called physical layer. Actually, I'll tell you one thing. I said you there are 7 layers, right? 1, 2, 3, okay, 7 layers, right? This is application layer, presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, and physical layer. This is the 7 layers diagram, okay? But the counting sequence of the diagram will not be like this. This will be the first layer. This will be the second layer, third layer, fourth layer, fifth, sixth, and seventh, okay? So we should excuse me, we should start counting the layers from bottom. So first layer will be the physical layer. The physical layer is the layer which will convert the task of the physical layer. Now let us discuss. Okay, physical layer task is to convert the data into bits. Okay, this is the task of the physical layer. Okay, and it lays the transmission medium between the devices. Transmission medium between devices means, I'll explain you. See, this is the physical device of physical layer of device A, and this is the physical device of physical layer of device B. There should be a transmission medium between these two devices in order to transfer the information from one device to another device. So physical layer provides that transmission medium. Okay, so this is the task which is done by the physical layer. And now let us see what are the other characteristics and what are the other things which are done by the physical layer, okay? The first one is it provides transmission medium. Second one is it converts the data into bits, okay? It converts the data into bits. And next is it provides the topology, physical topology. Topology, I have done a video on topology, so check out that video in my channel. Topology, roughly I'll explain you now. Topology means it explains the representation. It explains the representation between devices and links. I'll say you, if there are two devices and these two devices are linked, the topology explains the relationship between these devices and the links. Okay, this is only known as topology. Now, next layer is data link layer. Data link layer task is frames or framing. Framing is nothing but the data will divide the bits into frames. See, I'll explain you what is framing. Framing means, see, if this is total data which is available, A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, data link layer will divide the data into frames. This is frame 1. This is frame 2. This is frame 3. Like this. So that it will be so easy to transfer the information from one layer to another layer. So data link layer will divide the bits into frames. Okay, so it is called as framing. Okay, and second one is flow control. The task which is done by data link layer is flow control. Flow control means if there are two devices or two layers, if the sending device and this is receiving device, okay, if the sending speed of the device A is 50 words per second and if the receiving device B speed is only 20 words per second, the remaining data will be lost because it is not capable of receiving the data in the same speed of sending device. It is sending fastly and it is receiving slowly, so the data will be lost. So there should be a flow control. Like the data link layer will control the flow of the data from one device to another device. Okay, and the next layer is network layer. Okay, network layer, the name itself is explaining. It explains about the network of the devices. Network of the device means the network layer takes the responsibility to transfer the data successfully from source to destination. Source means the device which is the place at which the data is starting. Okay, example, I'll say you, this is device A and this is device B, this is sending device and this is receiving device. Okay, then this will be the destination because this is a place or device where the data needs to be received. So this is destination, this is the final destination. this is the final destination and this is source, because from this source only the data is starting to send. Okay, so this is called network layer. And next is transport layer. Coming to transport layer, see, it is similar to network layer. Network layer will concentrate on transfer of the data from source to destination, whereas transport layer will concentrate on delivery of the data from one process to another process. From one process to another process. That means if there are many processes in the architecture, from this process to this process, delivery of the data will be looked out by transport layer. Okay, it makes sure that the delivery of the data is done successfully from one process to another process. This is the task of the transport layer. Okay, and another task of the transport layer is segmentation and reassembly. Means this is the data available. Okay, first it segments the data. Okay, this is device A and this is device A and this is device B. While sending the data will be segmented into parts, and after reaching to final destination, all the segmented parts will be again reassembled. Okay, again reassembled into original data. This is the task done by the transport layer. Next is session layer. Session layer means session layer concentrates on the synchronization. That is, it looks after the device A and device B, that is the sending device and receiving device. Sending device and receiving device has a synchronization. Means the if the sending device speed is 80 words per second and receiving device is 20 words per second, it means that there is no synchronization, because sending device speed is more than receiving device, so there is no synchronization. So now we should establish the synchronization between sending device and receiving device. This task is done by the session layer. Okay, and the last and final layer, last second layer, is known as presentation layer. It concerns, means it looks after the information which is exchanged between two systems. Okay, see, between two systems. Okay, I'll explain you what is this presentation layer. Okay, normally when there are two systems, when there are system A and system B, the information will be transferred from one system to another system, right? So that information will be exchanged between two systems with the help of presentation layer. And the presentation layer will also look after the syntax of the layer. That is, it takes care that the data which is sent by the system A is in the format which is acceptable by the system B. Example, if system B accepts only bits, then with the help of presentation layer, we will convert the data into bits so that the system B can easily accept the data, because it is in the same format which is easily acceptable by the system B. This work is done by the presentation layer. And other few tasks which are done by the presentation layer is encryption. Means Encryption means changing the data format from the readable form to unreadable form, okay? So that there will be a security and privacy to the data. There will be no hackers then, okay? This is called encryption. And compression. Compression also will be done by the presentation layer. Compression means if there is 50 MB of data, it reduces to 25 MB of data, means it reduces the store the length of the data, so that we can save the storage capacity, storage memory of the system, okay? And the last device is called last layer is called application layer. Application layer is very easy. Application layer is nothing but it helps in file transfer. It helps in file transfer and it provides mail services. These are the tasks which are done by all the 7 OSI ISO model layers. So yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.